Hello everybody and good day to you all today. I am talking about the Shameless season number 8, episode number 2, Where's My Meth? This episode directed by Anthony Hemingway. And here we have a lot of things going down in the crazy world of the Gallaghers. We have Frank Gallagher. He has a job. A legit job. Yeah. And he's actually doing quite well, which is quite shocking. He got his own bank account and a phone. He's trying to be a grown-up. After all the years of scamming the system, finding the easy way out, now that Monica's dead, he wants to be part of society. Who knew? How long is this going to last? Beats me. But for now, he's working hard and he's doing a pretty good job. He's quite impressive. Matter of fact, he's impressing his boss. He thinks I'm moving up the manager. This is when he started. Amazing. Then you have Fiona. She got 18 jobs, and one of them is she owns this apartment complex, and she's pretty much trying to get the people there, the tenants, to pay their rent. And since she knows how they feel, she's been in that place before, she's been broke a lot of times, and she's been high on her rent too. And so she's trying to be lenient, trying to be nice, trying to be forgiving, trying to work alongside them, and these people are just pissing her off, and she might have to put her hammer, try to put her foot down, because they're not going to pay their rent unless she forces them to. Because if they don't pay, they got to go. Because she has another tenant there, Nessa, who likes her and became friends with her, pretty much told her, Fiona, you can't be nice to these people. You cannot be nice to them. You have to pretty much put your foot down, let them know who's boss. And if they don't pay, kick them out. Yeah. Then you have Lip. Lip has been trying to get back Sierra for a while now, by any means possible. And for right now, he's babysitting her son to try to worm his way back into her life. Because he feels as though Charlie is not good enough for her. And since Charlie's an addict too, he tried to lure Charlie back into that world by luring him with drugs. And that plan doesn't quite work out the way he thinks it does. Yes. Then you have Liam. Liam is going to this fancy school, and he met a new friend. He got a new friend named Dylan. Now Dylan's rich, and Liam is not. And so Liam gets to see how the other half lives, and he is, wow, quite amazed. He says, "Oh my gosh, you got all these bathrooms. You got your own bathroom. You have a TV. You have all these rooms. Like, oh my gosh, wow." He's amazed. And then Dylan gets to see where Liam lives. And well, and now the thing is though, Dylan was a little scared at first. But once he was hanging with his friend, he was fine. He was okay. It was his mom and the nanny that was kind of weird. Yeah, it was all weird. I was just like, holy mother. The thing is, the funny part was when the nanny was driving Liam home, and she was seeing this neighborhood, and she saw the fights. She saw fights breaking out in the streets. The police arresting people. And then she saw Liam. She stopped up to Liam's house, and there was a fight. Guys were fighting. And she goes, no, go outside. You won't be safe. And Liam looked like, no, what? Whatever. I'm fine. I'll see you later. Just walked out and went home. What are you freaking out for? It's a big thing. I see this every day. I know what I'm doing. Peace out. Yeah, that part was funny. Then you have Deb, and Deb has fought for this life she had with Neil for a long, long time. She fought to be with him. She thought this ain't gonna be a family, and now that she's starting to become she's going to school, trying to become a welder, and she meets new people in her life. She pretty much forgot all about him, pretty much kicked him to the curb, because now she's got this new guy in her life, Duran. Played by Bracket, who's in the hair. He loves Deb's hair, and maybe some other stuff too. I don't know. But either way, the whole thing Deb is fighting for, she's pretty much pushing aside. Yeah. All for this new life she's creating. I'm happy to see that she's trying. She has a career she wants to do, and she's happy doing it. But the fact that she pushes aside this guy, who pretty much depends on her. And then that she's just like kicking him to the curb. It's kind of messed up. Really is. Yeah. Then you have Kev and Veronica. They're going through it because Kev found a lump, a A doctor found a lump in Kev's chest. This was freaking him out because he thinks he might have cancer. Kev's going to special support groups, and he's talking to the women. And Kev is so stupid, but it was so funny, especially when he had to do it. It was time for him to talk, and he's talking about how he's scared that he won't be able to let men fill him up for tips anymore. I just like, what kind of mess is that? And when they responded to it, I just say, what? It was just so funny to me. And especially this another scene they have of when Kev and Veronica's in the hospital, and he was going under surgery, and they start singing Boys to Men, End of the Road, because he wants that song to be played at his funeral. And that was just so dumb. I mean, I couldn't stop laughing. So overall, this was a great episode. I really enjoyed this episode. It was funny. It was touching, because you're also watching Ian. He's still pretty much he's the only one who's pretty much mourning Monica. He's starting to feel the weight that his mom is gone, because he pretty much connects to her the most, because they pretty much have a lot in common, because he shares her disease, and so I guess in some way he's still connected to her that they're not, and they pretty much moved on. Are you crying over Monica? Like get over it, man. She wasn't much of a mother to us, and even though he knows that too, he still has a connection with her. That they will never have. Yeah, so he pretty much mourned her in the episode too. So like I said, overall, great episode. Really enjoyed a whole lot. This crazy family is just so crazy, but I am enjoying them. I don't know how long Frank is going to stay in the right path, but I'm enjoying that too. So let's see where this goes. So leave your comments down below. Let me know what you thought about this episode of Shameless. And if you haven't watched Shameless, check it out for yourself. Don't take my word for it. Check it out for yourself. Hopefully when you watch it, you will enjoy it and have fun watching it too. So give my channel a big old like to hit the thumbs up. Boom! And subscribe to my channel and share. I really appreciate it, like I always say, in my dreams and in my life. I am the Ninja Rabbit. Peace out, peoples.